a look at perspective, one-point perspective, from where we are standing, not on a bridge, not sitting down, but actually standing up. Let's have a look what happens to perspective when we are in a standing position. And let's draw a horizon line. So we have the horizon line, which is always on your eye level. And one point perspective, so take a point, you're standing down, you're looking at virtually down in the middle. So let's draw a pencil line from there downwards to start getting that right. Now we have a nice little road, and let's say the bottom of what we where we're standing is basically at this position here. So let's take that across here. And we're standing in the middle of the road. So what happens? This is your head. Your eye height is there. And you just draw a person sort of more or less looking the other way. But anyway, this is, let's do that. Light's coming from the side. And there's a person standing here. I'm not going to go into too much detail, just want to sort of get an idea. So, in other words, if you're standing on a flat plane, let's put down here, on a flat plane, no hills, no humps and bumps. This is what happens. Your eye will always be on horizon. Doesn't matter whether there's a hill or a house in the front of you, if you're standing straight up, looking straight ahead, your eye will always be on the horizon height. So, okay, let's say we got a road. Now, that road is pretty wide. Let's say, this is a narrow road. So, what I'm trying to get at is, if you're going closer down and apart from looking higher up, this is going to be much wider to there. So you need to remember that when you're also busy with roads, etc. So there's a vanishing point, goes through to there. That vanishing point is going to be roughly across here. There's your road going across. Now, we have a little fence that's going along the side of the road. Let's put that little fence in. And that fence will, say, run from here to there. So you've got that fence. It's a wooden pole, so let's draw some of these ones in. Draw a center line through there. That one, next fence is going to be, our pole is going to be here. Next one's going to be here. And then from here, it gets closer. Closer and closer. and disappears there at the vanishing point. We have a row of telephone poles which will go along this line, and they appear. So your first poles are looking up to here. Let's do that in pink. The first telephone pole is going to be here. Might as well just draw that like that quickly. Put the tops in later. And let's see, did I get that exactly halfway? Yeah, roughly. So, okay. So here's the center line. Let's say the next pole is going to be here. There is that line, this one here, there, there. Remember in the first video I showed you how to do these lines, that line through to there, there's that line here, across here. That's where the next telephone pole is going to be. Thinner, thinner. And that one, next pole is going to be here. That's there. Get closer and closer and closer together. That one there. And let's just draw the other ones in. They're going to get closer and closer. And then we have a... I'm just going to rough it in. Telephone pole across here. Down that way. So let's do our fence post. And disappear down the side. In our road. Remember, this was here the vanishing point, and if we add in here a whole row of these boxes. Say the boxes are like that. Bring this one down a bit further. Those are the tops of the boxes, so that one is going to be there, and let's make the other one say about that wide. And there. So let's do that. Get it in. Now we need to add in that the row of boxes, and the next construction line through the vanishing point is to here. So these are the verticals and those are the horizontals. So Let's add them in. So you've got a box here. There's a little gap. There's the next box. It's going to be here. Little gap. Next one's going to be here. Tiny little gap. Next one's going to be there. And also, you can see it gets narrow and narrow and narrow, similar to what's happening along here. Okay, so let's. One mind is missing there. On the top of that one, there's one. There we go. There's a wrong pen. This one. Just move the top. In. And we do the bottom one. In other words, this is just a sort of like a simulation of a train and the coaches going down. They will all look like that, obviously, with drawn properly. But now, if it's a long train, that will carry on and on and on and get smaller and smaller and smaller and smaller. And here we have a row of trees going down here. So let's on that line. We start a bit away from the railway line, and those trees also come up here. They're not very tall trees. They're still the young ones, so let's put those in. They will have a lot of these plane trees. They have another one coming across here. Assuming they're all the same height. Come a little bit closer. That one a little bit closer. This one a little bit closer. What happens is now they start doing that. Then this one will be there. After a while, all you're gonna see is this. Then they get closer and closer and closer and closer together. And if there's one here, that one will be about here somewhere. Because what happens if you stand here, you're looking sideways, you see a bigger gap, and as you go down here, that gap gets smaller and gets closer together. So we've got that. And, right, we got that. Right, we need to add a little. Wires go in, and those one also, each one of these run all the way towards the vanishing point. Right across there. Then we have a row of little bushes down the side here. Let's put them in. And we're going to draw a little pencil line, put the through the vanishing point. All these little bushes are small little bushes here. As we get here, they started getting closer and closer to each other, and here you're going to, they sort of disappear. And let's say there's another person standing over here. There's his feet. Now there's going to be roughly the same height. It's going to be here. And his belly button's halfway there, so you've got the hips up here. Standing down here, you've got the shoulder. There. And you've got another person standing on the here on this edge. He's going to be there. So here you have the person standing there, there, and there. So in other words, all the people will be on those right. So okay, let's go along and start putting it in. And the old sun is on this side from over the shoulder. So all that. So let's give it a little bit of color. So it starts making a bit of sense. So you can see the different colors from between the. Now let's add some sky. In my brush, where's my, let's clean it out. Just want to add some water in there. If you pick up your brush and hold it sideways, you can carry quite a bit of water. Okay, let's get some of the blue. A slight little mix, which is quite nice. You don't have a sky that is too bright. So, right, let's add a little mountain here too, or some little hills in the background. Here we've got a few little hills. And you don't see it across here, and that will start going across there. Let's say this is complete flat right through to the horizon. Okay, now we can just add some sky in. Some green hills. Those are trees. We don't see in between. Thank you. that's about it for another one point perspective drawing. So you get an idea of happening, and this is on a flat plane, and notice big thing is that if you're standing on a flat ground, the horizon is always on the horizon level. Doesn't matter where you're standing, whether you're standing right at the back here or other, it's always on there. Obviously if you've got a little kid, that little kid is going to be down here, but your drawing is with relative to a kid, it's going to be that, then your grown-up will be up top here, the face. So it must be relative to the size of the person that you are doing your perspective to. So there we have it. Until we meet again in another video, keep well.